Hello, I'm Mr. Arninger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam of Allah. Allah is Noor, Spirit, Sun, and not Moon and Star. So real Islam is quite different from what you hear about this. Jesus and his second coming, Nanak, both preach Islam. But the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our father himself came in the name of Gobind Rai, and he organized soldiers of Akal Purakh or of God, soldiers of God, philanthropic. They did not fight for money, they fight for God. And still it could not be comprehended. And now the last time has come. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. The tares are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning, which is expected around 2023 in May, when Israel will be 70 plus 5 years old. Five are related to the five temptation of the heart in a house. In a house there are five, three against two, two against three. If you understand this one, great. And I have explained this one in the Trinity. You will find it in description. I'm very happy to help you. But if you are looking for gospel, here is I'm doing Luke 5 verse 1 to 11. Once while Jesus was standing beside the lake of Gennesaret. Remember, this Gennesaret is a very important place. Here, you know, Jesus gave the sermon, and a couple of people, you know, got interested in it and they understood it. And then they wanted to tell the other people, look, gospel, good news. Listen to us. Our rabbi is not good. He is a hypocrite. Because they were the stooges of the rabbi, and rabbi told them, as you see them, the Pope, you know, telling, was burning people at stake. So were the rabbis. They were not that harsh. So rabbi told them, lock them in the silence of the graveyard. Nobody will listen to them. Then it will be useless. But as gospel was in their heart, nobody could bind them. So they were breaking chain and coming to roadside again like these Jehovah's Witnesses do, knocking on the doors and trying to tell people. They again locked them in the graveyard silence. Then Jesus went there to rescue him, to redeem him. And when he went there, he immediately recognized Son of the Most High. He honored him. And Jesus told him, don't throw pearls before swine. They will turn around and trample you. That is what they did. They turn around, they lock him in the silence of the graveyard. Then he made 2,000 swine to drown in this lake, Gennesaret. That is their fate. So here are what I've written. And the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God. That way they were very eager. He saw two boats there at the shore of the lake where Jesus made 2,000 swine to drown, as the people of this town had locked one of his laborers in the silence of the graveyard. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. They were not so interested in the gospel than making money. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little way from the shore. Then he sat down and preached the crowds from the boat. Now, here they put taught, you know, it's wrong, you know, because Jesus was a preacher of gospel and not the teacher of the letters. So these Jewish people, when they occupied the church, they bring in their old temple practices into the New Testament, into the Church of God. They corrupted, they killed it. The crowds from the boat. Our lives are like the boat in the sea. Our lives are like boat in the sea, up and down, up and down. And if you have Christ in your heart, are at stern to guide our lives. Remember when Jesus was in the boat, he was sitting at the stern of the boat. That means he was heading the boat, he was controlling the boat, but he was asleep. And the boat started rocking due to storm. Peter was frightened because he was the once born. The twice born was sitting quietly, that we are in safe hand. So he woke him up. Master, master, get up. We are drowning. Then there is no problem when Christ is in the storm, in the boat, in the stern. Christ is in your heart. This is the guest house. You need to prepare it for Christ to enjoy his Passover and other meals. Remember the story of the Passover when Jesus baptized his 11 laborers into the royal kingdom of God. Judas Iscariot was thrown out. I can tell much more in detail about that story. At this turn to guide our lives, then there is no problem in the calming down our heavels. That means up and down of the life, heavels of life. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water, let down your nets for a catch." Simon answered, deep water, that means where people are can think deep. This gospel is not for those who think shallow. They just read the letters of the Bible, New Testament. That's it. They don't want to know what is hidden underneath. You have to go deep into the scripture. And that is what Jesus told him. Put the boat in deep water. Master, we have worked all night long but have caught nothing. Yet if you say so, I will let the nets. This he obeyed, Christ Jesus, the one sitting in our heart, the guest room, this is the guest room, to celebrate with us. When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break. So they signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. You know, when you have gospel, you share with people. As that man in Gennesaret who was locked in the graveyard, he was trying to share with the people, but people had no ears to hear his word. So they call him a madman. And they came and filled both boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Go away from me, Lord, I am a sinful man. That is why he said he can't catch the fish, you know, because he is full of sins. But he was speaking from his heart, not superficial. There are many people in the world which in their heart they speak out the gospel truth, like Peter did here, like little children. They are listened. Simon was a simpleton, once born clean-hearted person. He expressed what was inside him like a little child, for he and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of fish that they had taken, and so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching people, men, you know." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and joined and not followed him as blind follow others. You know the word follow, it is wrong in the Bible, because the blind people follow others. As these university students, they follow their blind professors without understanding. They just do what they tell them to do, otherwise they will fail the class, or the professor will call me heretic, because like me, when I go to Oxford University, they think of me as a heretic, you know, and sometimes they will tell me, "Hey, Gnostics are heretic, you know, you are one of them." So I laugh at them. So that this miracle convinced Simon to join the company of Christ Jesus. Now Jesus has made us the fishers of men, not of women. Now, in spiritual sense, there are these men and women language is metaphor. And only those people will understand who can think logically or who are capable of logical reasoning. Men are the masters of the house. And this is the house. When you are master of your house, John 9, born blind person was, he was telling the rabbis from his own heart, not asking his parent or anybody else to asking them before he say anything to the rabbis. He was asking them from his own heart and questioning them, you know, that do you want to become his disciples too? So such attitude when you have, you know, when you are master of your own destiny and you are outspoken, then you are the man. Then you are the man. And such people are to be fished. We are fishers of men only, spiritual men. Now the women are those who follow others blindly, as the rabbis they were following. And as the people follow Pope and these dog holder priests, whatever they tell them, they do it. And if I go to a church and say something, no, our priests say this thing, so I'm wrong. So these people are women, or they cannot be fished. You can't make them to come into the royal kingdom of God. You need to be solitary and seeker of the narrow gate. When you find the narrow gate, you enter it. Then you find the true vine, Christ Jesus, planted by our Father in the middle of the vineyard. You graft yourself to him, eat his fruit with these ears, listen to him, and then preach gospel as I am doing to you now. So our Father God blesses you, and if you need any help, please let me know. God blesses you.